What doing when that what doing when that fat boy's tripping?
Fairshare is the largest food charity in the UK, originally set up about 15 years ago as part of another charity called Crisis. But 10 years ago, Fairshare went on its own. It's now a major charity, headquartered in London, but operating 12 franchises across the UK in major cities and urban parts of the UK, where we're able to intercept surplus food from manufacturers and retailers before it becomes waste, and intercepting that and through a network of warehouses and delivery vehicles, getting that to needy people, disadvantaged people, homeless people around those areas, and providing food for them.
So mainstream's getting a little bit formulaic and basic, really.
No, I don't love you anymore.
October 2008, I'd never ever heard any of this dubstep stuff before, and then I got introduced to Scream, Benga, Koki, all these people. But I think Bristol sort of vibes off that whole new experimental sound as produced by Massive Attack, that they sort of brought that whole bass forward.
Centre Space is a not-for-profit gallery space for hire, and it's run almost entirely by volunteers. We support local, national, international artists, up-and-coming and established ones.
I think it's a really good place for painters and artists to come because it's right in the centre of Bristol. City. There's quite a good catchment area, and it is one of the most well-known galleries in Bristol. It's been here for about 10 years.
Buildings themselves still exist. They're all in Ashley Down Road. Four of them now are used by Bristol City College, and the fifth house, which is actually what we call number three house, was sold a few years ago and now private residences. One morning, the children all came down for breakfast and the tables were laid. They all sat down, but there was no food in the house. But George continued to sit them down, ready for the meal, and they started giving thanks. And as they're saying thank you for the food that they're about to eat, there's a knock on the door from the baker, who the night before just felt very, very strongly that he ought to bake some bread for the orphanage. And he got up, went back down to his bakery, and spent the whole night baking bread and delivered it as they were saying Amen.